Wow. Let me tell you, these freaking railroad ties. There was two big old corn-fed Texas boys loading this sucker, and I loaded one, and then another guy came out to help him. And the first one, I was like, damn, I'm still my damn back. These damn things are heavy. I mean, shit. I had no idea. I'm going to line these around my mats so my mats don't slide out. So I'm going to put these around, see these black mats? Here's the plan anyway. I'm going to put these railroad ties kind of straight down here. I'm going to turn these mats longwise, so it's going to go a little bit further there. So I'm going to add four more mats behind these four mats, and then I'm going to put a railroad tie here, and then cut and put a railroad tie straight across here, and then straight up here. So that'll make it a little bit bigger wash rack area. It'll extend it out about 8 inches, because the railroad ties are 8 inches out. So it'll extend it out 8 inches on the back and 8 inches that way. And that keeps these mats from separating, because they're always kind of moving and separating. So if I set these upright, these mats will be so tight, there's not going to be a lot of room in between them, and I won't have this separation. So, but I can't move those freaking things. I don't know how I'm going to get those off. I was thinking of backing the truck up here, tying a rope to here, and then tying the railroad tie to the tree, and then driving the truck off, and it would drag it out. Those stinking suckers are freaking heavy. One dude picked up one, he goes, oh, this one's really heavy. I go, they're all freaking heavy. He goes, no, this one's really heavy. So evidently they vary between weight, between 200 and 300 pounds each. $25, I think, a 26 at Home Depot, but they're supposed to last for freaking ever. So since they're gonna be buried in a ground, probably up to here, and then the mat will be making it level, and the horses shouldn't be able to hurt it walking on it. They got that creosote, so the bugs shouldn't get it. So another damn project. So I didn't get the approach because I was feeding them, but if I get Buddy right here and get him in this corner where he's used to, Ransom will come in as long as there's a gap. But When I put food in here, I have to put it over here first to keep Buddy here. Otherwise, he will move over and cause a block, and then Ransom won't come in. So even throwing food in a bucket is kind of a planning a little bit, that I'm trying to make it easy for them to find the right answer. The right answer is they both get to come in and eat. So I've got to make that easy. And I do that by setting Buddy up over here where he's used to be. Ransom doesn't want to be trapped. He knows he's a little horse. Mr. T was high horse. He didn't mind being by the wall because Buddy wouldn't push him. He doesn't want to be pushed into the wall. So at first I was trying to feed Buddy over here and have him come over here, but it wasn't working. Buddy was, it was too easy for Buddy to move over and kind of block him. So I had to change my theory and put Buddy where he's comfortable and try to get Ransom to come in where he's blocked. So that's how I've got them to where I do it. Now I'm gonna go in and squirt Ransom's legs because he hates freaking the fly spray. You know, you'd think as much as I've been doing it, but if he's really eating, he ignores me. But if he's got anything else, see, his head already went up. He's like, dude, I know he's coming in with that damn spray shit. And I see the little flies falling, so I know there's little flies. I'm a little leery of his back feet until I know he knows I'm here, because I don't want him to. I know he hates it. I think it gets in his eyes and it stings, because when it gets in my eyes, it stings. So there's that negative, trying to get a horse to accept something that hurts him and stings. So I really have to concentrate on spraying his legs and keeping it away from his eyes. I get asked 50 million times and I keep telling people what fly spray I use. That's what I use. So Buddy's kind of nudging his way over there, but Ransom's kind of holding his own a little bit. They're getting more comfortable, and Ransom isn't so, I guess what I call shell shock, to where, oh my God, there's another horse. I don't want to be kicked out of the herd. I really enjoy having a horse, you know. So he's so willing to please that that he was almost flighty to any movement of Buddy. And now he's kind of getting us a little bit of confidence. I mean, he's got some bite marks on him, and he does get pushy on me. So I understand that, Buddy. All right, we'll give you a little bit more oats because you guys are being good. So again, they don't get a whole bunch. I mean, it's just, this is like a half a cup of oats here. I just kind of spread it out and let them snack on it. Let the little vacuum cleaners do their job. They love their oats. Now there's this one vet, I think I shared his video. He's kind of an anti-oat dude, and I like most things he says. And he doesn't like feeding oats, even though oats have been fed to horses for freaking years. I mean, I think, like most things with horses, moderation is key. You want it. I ordered a little brush on Amazon since I gave my other one away, so sometimes I brush Buddy's little hair. He doesn't like it. And I'll brush little rants. So this is how you get a horse to let him brush your forelocks. You feed them, and then you do it while they're doing it. They don't care. So sometimes when there's twigs in there, I'll brush it with a regular brush, and it doesn't really work. So this little brush is maybe for their bangs. I got a couple little curry combs here. I got my fly spray. This is another curry comb. This is a little kitty rake. It's like the big rake here. This is for deferring. This is for their removing bot eggs. And this is the little defur that I use on Moki Cat and the horses sometimes. And I had this sitting around. I need to use it. I pulled it out when little Belle was over here because her hair was so bad. And this was in my horse trailer. I never use it. So I think I had it for like parades or something. And so I put it out here, so now I can just spray it when I need it. Then I have a little soft brush over here. And all my my tools, that's my RAS, the other thing, my nippers, and my hoof stand. And then my little medicine cabinet, you guys saw that I did. I haven't got the mats yet. I was looking for different mats to put down here. But... So that's and there's the horse. If you okay, and the horses see themselves, I think they can. Hi, boys. Are you guys being good boys? I know you guys are good boys. So that's my bleach for my septic tank. You throw the little tubes down there as the water runs by it. So those are empty. Because it puts a little smell out. I didn't want to put it right under where they eat. So you see Ransom? See, he's kind of got a back out here. So it's not a real good, comfortable spot for him. He's probably got a little piece of grain there. And he'll go over and lick that white salt block. I don't know why they don't use the mineral block, but they both, ever since Mr. T left, they both go for the white mineral block. Mr. T always went for the mineral block, the brown one. But these guys both go for just the plain salt. And it's funny, they always go to the salt after I give them grain. But he's scratching his jaw. Did that feel good, little buddy boy? You got an itch? I'm like, yeah, Dad, I got an itch. I know, he's a good boy. Alrighty. So I had this out for, I don't know what other tool I got in here. I don't think I have any other tools. My light worked. One of my videos, my light didn't work the other day. I opened it up and I turned a switch on. It didn't work. But for some reason, it just turned on. So I think I had not turned it on in a long time. But I left it on. I came out here in the middle of the night checking on them. And I saw my light on. I go, how the hell did that light get on? I must have left it on earlier. So somehow, if I don't use this a lot, maybe it's just the internals. It's probably meant to be inside a garage and not outside. So it's getting a lot of dust and dirt and crap. So... That's why that, and I plug those up so little wasps don't get in there. What the hell else? I think that's it. Wheelbarrow's out because I've been doing, what are you boys doing? Man, digging these freaking, moving these monster freaking 300 pound logs. My freaking back is killing me. Then I'm out here with a shovel. It took me almost 2 hours just to dig this out from this clay, and I still didn't go long enough for it to lay down. So I want it to lay down about this. I want it to be up a little lower than this so I don't have to edge. If it's up, then I can't run a lawnmower over it. But if it's almost equal with the mats, I just run the lawnmower over it. So I'm gonna put one over here. I'm gonna square that corner, one over here, and that'll stop these mats from moving this way. This will stop the mats from moving that way, and hopefully it'll keep these seams a little bit tighter. And then I just dropped off two mats over here. The horses were over here because I got some out there. I got a guy coming out to see about concreting that today too. But I haven't moved these mats yet. My little 4th of July flag, flying proud. 13 stars, original 13 colonies. When we told the Brits and the Redcoats to get the hell out, I'm tired of living under your king shit. And now we got other freaking king politicians that are in office for Biden 50 years. And we're like, yay, we're free, we got rid of. Anyway, I digress, I don't wanna get on that. So I got these two mats here that I need to move. And I just put one in front of this side of the gate and one on that side. And again, any path, anytime you run horses or people through something, you're gonna get it wear down, you're gonna lose dirt, it sticks to your shoes, it sticks to the horse's hooves, and it slowly erodes. So these mats, because this is a pathway and it's funneled, will help stop that erosion of, you know, in the same way with these things, when I put that stuff here. You know, as the horses walk through, they carry away mud, they make hoof prints, some of it sticks to the mud, and over time, you lose ground. So I put this stuff here and it's held up pretty good. You can tell where it thins out, it still turns into mud. So I tell people, if you're going to use this, you can't just throw it out there and don't, you got to wet it and pound it. I wetted it and drove my truck over it, drove the golf cart over it and wetted it and really packed it. Then it holds up. But if you don't pack it and it's not thick enough, it just basically blends into the mud. It's not quite as bad, but in a couple years, this mud will be as bad as this area used to be. You can tell right here, again, a pathway. They come to the gate from here. So we're losing mud and we're getting erosion here. So anyway, all right, we'll end that there with all my crazy projects. So I've got a guy coming out to give me an estimate on maybe putting concrete where the horse is walking. Here and concrete in this pad right here. You can tell. So I have these two rubber mats here. Again, same reason, cut down erosion for the gates. And then I just drug these two mats in because I made it more square. So I have three, they're 4x6s. So 3 × 6 is 18 feet this way. 3 × 4 is 12, is 12 feet this way. 12x18 gives me my square footage. This is an extra one that I use to, I put over this little water thing here in the winter to stop my pipe from freezing, because I have a water pipe here. And when it gets really cold, I don't want it to freeze. And since it's exposed underneath here, I just pull one of those mats over it. Buddy just saw the gate open. You ain't coming out, boy. I know you're paying attention. You think you're slick. I saw you trying to escape. I can't ever leave this gate open. I'm taking that boy, he'll be like, I'm out. Dad left the gate open. I'm free because I'm so abused, trapped in here. I'm so abused and my dad is so mean to me. So I got a couple of these railroad ties moved out here. We're gonna talk about my back, but so these two, if he doesn't put concrete, I'm gonna kind of border this in railroad ties to keep these mats together. But you can tell it's already kind of eroding out here. And I'm getting, it's very uneven. It erodes over there because I dump my water. And when I dump my water, because I clean it, you have to dump water. So anytime you have a water spot, you need to figure out where's all that water gonna go if I clean it. Most people don't because they don't freaking clean it. Put freaking fish in there and think that's cleaning or some shit. So that's a new mat. And he's kind of like been checking out the new mats. Like, hey, these are new smells. He had to come over and check this one out. Now he's got to check that one out. Oh, that gate can't open. I know what he's doing. He's trying to sneak over that gate. You ain't being slick. I see you. Hi, Ransom. Put a little tack off here so they don't try to eat it. So you can tell where the mats were. I had these long wise right here, and I moved them to where it made more of a rectangular square. Let's see. I guess if I put another one four there, 4 and 4 16. Oh, you know what? That would make it square. I was talking to my buddy and he's like, yeah, you can make it square. And I go, man, how can I make it square with rope? Hi, bud. These are just little mats. You can't eat them. No, you can't eat them. I know what you're trying to do. So his little hoof bone does look kind of a ring bone there. Looks swollen a little bit, which is why he might be limping. So he seems a little tenderfooted on that right front. And I also wanted to mention, I had a, he had a little cut here. Let me see. Buddy, don't you go out there. It's okay, Ransom. I'm not talking to you, bud. You're okay. Buddy's being a bad boy. So I thought he had a little hole in one of his little hooves. That water needs to be cleaned. They come out here and rinse their mouth out. It's really not, the dirty water isn't dirty. It just looks dirty at the bottom, and I don't like that. So I'll end up cleaning that today. But I can't see his little, he had a little hole on one of his hooves. I'm just thinking, it might be covered with mud. Is that it? I thought he had a little compromised hoof wall there on one of his rear feet. Yeah, see right there, it looks like there's a little chip in his hoof wall. Let me check his other one. He's like, dude, why are you messing with my feet? I ain't got the fly spray, so chill out, boy. Acting all nervous on me. All right, I don't see it over here. So it must have been that one, but it looked more pronounced. It was more like a hole. And somebody goes, man, that's an abscess that blew out. I go, I don't think so. I think he just hit it on something. Maybe on a rock or something. And this thing, of course, keeps the sun off so it doesn't heat up the water. As the water gets warm, it's not as good for them to drink, and it builds algae quicker. So by covering it with this white thing, only half of it gets sunlight. Look at Buddy inching his way over there. Boy, you are just cruising for a bruising. Don't make me go get a switch, because you're going to get a beating on YouTube like never before. Oh my goodness. Poor little buddy. He doesn't want to get a beating because he's a good boy. Because he's a good boy. He don't want to get a beating. I know. I know he doesn't. He doesn't want a beating. All right, Dad's got to close it. Watch your little head. Don't try to stop me. It's closing. Don't you say no to me. You're in big trouble. You know Dad don't like it when you say no. You're in big stinking trouble. See, so here we go. We have two horses coming here because I'm a draw. And they're standing here. What does that do? It knocks down the dirt. It pounds it in. When I was digging out, you notice there's like fresh dirt under here. When I was digging out for that railroad tie, I dumped a wheelbarrow of dirt underneath here to help rebuild this up. So that's all fresh dirt because it just gets packed down from horses either going in and out, me going in and out, wheelbarrow going in and out, golf cart going in and out, lawnmower going in and out. Anytime you funnel things through an area, you're going to get that pack down effect, which creates indentations, which creates water storing, which creates all kind of things. So I'll let you know. I'll slide in a little thing. The guy's supposed to come out at noon today to give me a quote to concrete this area and maybe concrete this back area. I mean, this is held up pretty good, these blocks. And some people go, why don't you just do that in the horse area? I don't walk on this and I don't drive on this. And that's why it's held up. It has no traffic. I think if I did this out here, it would end up doing the same thing as the mud and the other stuff up there would do. So we'll see what the concrete guy says. All right. Okay, so I don't know if I made that clear on what I was going to do with these mats. So I grabbed my little handy grabber, and I just pulled them. And now, as I walk in and out of here, it stops the mud erosion right here. And because there's mud erosion, and horses and people walk through here, it packs it down, so you get a low spot. When you get a low spot, water gathers. I'm out of breath because I just drug these same things. And so then when you get a low spot, it creates water. Then it keeps it moist longer, and then when a horse steps on it, it gets more erosion. So anytime you're trying to get rid of the erosion in your path areas, it's pretty good. These are, shit, I think they were $42. They used to be like $25. And so I put those up. Some people use vice grips. they don't want to buy this little tool. I think this tool was, I don't know how much it was on Amazon, but it's really worth it. You just, when you push it, so when you slide it on the mat, it goes like that and then it grips it. And then you have a good handle. I mean, vice grips work, but this makes it a lot easier. I end up buying two and I really only use one. You put it in the middle and I can just drag it around that way. So that's how I move my mats. All right, we'll end that there. So Moki Cat must be slim pickings. There's a little dead animal he left me this morning. Looked like an endangered cricket. He did. A little shit did. I found a bird. I gotta go clean this up. You're in big trouble, mister. Quit killing me and bringing these animals. You're in big stinking trouble. I don't want your kills. I don't need them and I don't want them. You're in big trouble, mister. So that was one kill and I came back here today. Let me turn away. Oh, I gotta turn away. So because I haven't swept up this hay and I've been feeding the horses every time I pull, I found this little guy back here this morning. I don't need to do a crime scene. I know who the freaking, there's the last crime scene chalk out on. So yeah, I'm seeing your freaking little presence, boy. You're in big stinking trouble. Big trouble. Come here, I'll pet you. Before I spank you. Come on. Come on. Hop. Good boy. You're in big stinking trouble. I'm not going to put up with that anymore. Killing all those poor little animals. You're going to get big trouble. Big trouble. I've had it. You're in big stinking trouble. Get those little paws. I'm going to brush those paws. And that belly. You're in big trouble, mister. There ain't no sense in that. Look at you. You're still shedding hair. When we had this heat wave came in, man, he really started even shedding more hair. But anyway. No more dead animals, mister. All right. We'll end that there.